Hi everyone, welcome to Xinhua Live. I am Pan Qiang with the Xinhua News Agency. Today, we're at the World Cultural Heritage Site, Zhejiang Huashan, Rock Art Cultural Landscape. And the landscape is located in South China's Guangxi Zhuang Autonomous Region, which neighbors Vietnam. It is an extensive assembly of historical art that was painted on limestone cliff. The Huashan Rock Art site may be considered to be one of the most impressive prehistoric painted panels of the world. And today, we have invited one of the officials from Department of Tourism and Development in Ninming County, Mrs. Ma. So welcome, Mrs. Ma.
Hello, Mr. Pan. Okay. Welcome to Xinhua Alive.
Okay, thank you. And as we have seen from the clothes here, it's quite fresh. It's red. It's a different kind of colors. It's the one of the symbolic clothes of the Zhuang people. As we know, Zhuang ethnic group in China has the largest population in China, and the population of Zhuang people in China is 15 million people. So, could you tell us what's the time? Does the rock art built?
The landscape is believed to be 1800 and 2500 years old, which is painted by an ethnic group named Lo Ye. The depict human fingers as well as animals along with broad drums, knives, swords, bills and ships. Human fingers are typically between 16 centimeters and 115 centimeters tall, but one finger reaches 3 meters in height.
Wow, that's quite historical. It often heavily rains in that area and the winds are strong, but the paintings preserved very well and did not lose their colors for as many as 1,800 to 2,500 years. So when was the landscape listed in the World Heritage?
On July 15, 2013, Zhejiang Huashan Rock Art Cultural Landscape was listed as World Heritage Site. It is the 49th World Heritage Site in China. The local landscape is the first one of its kind of China's heritage.
Okay, and the paintings have a red color and were executed using a mixture of red ochre, animal glue and blood. They depict the human figures as well as animals along with the bronze drums, knives, swords, bells and ships. Could you give much more details about the gestures of the painting?
As we could see from the painting, the images on the log depicting drums and related elements are symbolic records directly associated with the bronze drum culture once widespread in the region.
And so, you know, today we're having the life of the Huashan Kung Fu. So what's the connections between the Huashan Rock Art and the Huashan Kung Fu? Could you give us much more details about that?
From the dress of the Huashan Kung Fu, especially the dress of the leg, we could know that.
Okay, you mean that from the gestures we have seen on the rock art, and the Huashan Kung Fu is inspired by the Huashan rock art.
Yeah.
And after 2,500 years, we could see the red color is also quite fresh on the rock. And from the red color and from the gestures, we could see that the shape is like sheep, and some of the shapes like fall and like frog, and there are some round shape like the bronze drums, and from the gestures of the people on the rock art, you could see that they're playing kung fu, or they're having some gestures to protect themselves. So after a long history, Why does the rock art still existing in the present? It's a mystery. It's quite mysterious. Why? Because outside of the rock art, it is raining right now. But the place where we stay is quite dry and there is no rain here. And I think it from the research of the rock art, and some of the experts told us that's why the rock art could be protected so well from a long history until now. Okay, hi everyone, welcome back and welcome to Xinhua Live. And as we know, Huashan rock art is one of the historical rock art in the world. In 2008, in the opening ceremony of 2008 Olympic Games, Huashan art is one of the content. And today, we will very happy to invite one of the successors of the Huashan Kung Fu, Mr. Gan Ming, to give us much more details about the Huashan Kung Fu and the history. 你好。 欢迎来到我们的新华直播间. Welcome to Xinhua Live, and please say hello to our audience.
对大家说一声好，大家好。你是哪一年开始做这个华山拳的这个传播的？华山拳传播是从2013年开始传播华山拳。For
the Huashan Kung Fu promotion, and Mr. Gan began to promote the Huashan Kung Fu in 2013.
那你是哪一年开始学这个华山拳的呢？我是从1972年跟我爷爷学习华山拳。1972年，对，1972年。Okay.
He started to learn the Huashan Kung Fu in 1972. 我们可以往下面。
OK，我一九七二年开始学，对，那是当时是谁教你的？当时是我爷爷教我的。He learned
the Huashan Kung Fu from his grandfather. And 当时怎么学的呢？当时我开始的时候，我这当时七二年是七岁的时候，人还是比较瘦小，爷爷呢可能就是为了给我强身健体吧，就教我那华山拳。Oh. Okay, when he was 7 years old, and he was a little bit weak, and to make him much stronger, so his grandfather asked him to learn the Huashan Kung Fu, and on the one side to protect himself from other people's attack, but on the other side to make him much stronger.
那你当时是学是有些什么样的这个招数呢？当时学是跟我们现在的华山壁画上的那个人物呢动作都很相似。Okay.
The gestures of the Huashan Kung Fu when he learned, and there are some of the gestures from the rock art on the rock.
是有哪些？你看哪些比较相似啊？从你看上面的那个华山岩画上的动作，这个很像啊，这里都像。哦。啊，对，他们都很像。
From the top of the rock art, and Mr. Gan said, and the gestures on the top is quite close to the Huashan Kung Fu, 很像，对吧？对。那怎么像呢？你看能不能？
能不能给我们做一下这个演示？啊，你看上面它有一个动作。哦，这个动作是哪个动作？这个动是来自于视频嘛？来自于像一只马，像是青蛙还是？啊，对，两个还是进攻，两个是也是隔开，也是那个夸山，啊，一个动作里面的。像马还是像青蛙还是？不是，应该是青蛙。青蛙啊，对。
The gesture, the inspiration of the gesture is from the frog. Frog is one of the most important animals in drum people. 青蛙当时是在我们壮族是一个非常重要的一个动物，对不对？对。那我们这个灵感是不是来自于青蛙？对，也是这样。And the inspiration, actually, it is from the frog. 那这个是青蛙在我们壮族这个发展当中是一个什么样的这个作用呢？
这个青蛙在我们发展这个是一个就是好像我们一个 民族里面对他一个崇拜，啊，崇拜的，
崇拜，
啊，对。
Frog is one of the worship of the drum people。
哎，那这个跟你们学这个功夫有什么联系？
啊，都有啊，因为他，因为我们啊练那个青蛙的动作，它还是比较灵敏的，动作还是比较有跳跃性，还是比较灵敏，动作还是啊对那个我们的发劲啊都是还有。
对，就青蛙它本身比较灵敏。
啊，对对，而且它里面的那个，青蛙里面的那个肚皮还是比较，比较就是说它空间比较大，啊，发的气还是比较锐利，还是比较大的。
And in Chinese Kung Fu, especially in Huashan Kung Fu, you know, the air in the belly is very important. How much the air in the belly you have, and how the strength will you give for your body, and as we know, the frog belly is quite big, and it's good for him to make the strength concentrate in a body or in a hand of the people.
那这个当时你除了学这个招式之外，还有什么招式啊？
啊，对，还有我们上面都有那个动物的名声，还有动物的动作。
动物的名称。
啊，对，动物动作。
哪些名称？
啊，比如说我们就是一个，夜猴摘果。
夜猴摘果。
对，夜猴摘果。
哪个动作？哪个？
夜猴。
Oh, it's the gesture. It is the gestures from monkey. And this gesture just like the monkey to take the fruits from the trees or from the some other kinds of the trees. 它是主要是去摘果。
摘果，但是主要是进攻人的眼睛。
人的眼睛。
对，你看这个手。
And as the kung fu is the purpose of kung fu is to one of the purposes is that to protect ourselves. So this gesture.Just like the monkey to take the fruits, it means we could attack other people's eyes. 我们可以通过这个动作去攻别人的眼睛。
对对。
哦。那还有什么招式啊？
那个在里面的他也有，还有将军扫腿也有，就是我们将军扫腿侧踩乾坤，还有猛虎出山。
猛虎。
啊，猛虎出山。
这个、什么这个动作、
啊？猛虎出山。
It's the gestures from the tiger.
Ha!
Wow, nice! It's quite spectacular.
And so this is what?
猛虎出山。
猛虎出山。
对。
The tiger came out from the mountain, and the tiger will come to attack some things.
它出山的意思就是要开始攻击。
对，对攻击，对攻击对方。
And also it means the people, the kung fu player will attack his enemies.
Right.还有
什么东西？啊，这个就是里面也很多。如果是要救的时候，我就可以从一套我们祖传下来的那个，那就是爷爷教我的宽拳，可以展示一下。
哦，那我们现在可以做一个展示吗？
对，可以。
Okay, we're so honored today, and Mr. Gan will show his kung fu to us. Okay, 我们可以在这边来展示吗？
好的。
Okay, wait a moment.Okay, let's get started. Let's begin. 开始吧。
HA!
Okay, thank you. 谢谢。打了这个有什么感觉？
啊，就是心里面就是打了就发过去了，这个人好像很舒服。
And after playing the Huashan Kung Fu, and he feels it's quite comfortable, and all of the annoyance in his mind has been out.
所有的这个烦恼是不是都会有一种出来的感觉？
对。
哦，那这个你每天是要练多久？
每天上午、早上都练，晚上都练。
早上都练，晚上都练。
对。
And every morning and every evening, and Mr. Gan will play at least for once every day.
那这个你从1972年开始学到现在已经有40多年了。
对。
是不是一直都坚持下来？
对，都坚持。
And from 1972 until now, and Mr. Gan persisted to playing Huashan Kung Fu every day, and it has been a long time.
那这个四十多年期间，你是从哪一年开始知道这个华山岩画跟你有这个关系的，跟你们这个华山拳？
好像1981年这样。
1981年。
对。
And from 1981, and Mr. Gan began to know that Huashan Kung Fu has some collections between the Huashan Kung Fu and the rock art. 为什么呢？
因为当时我在读高一。
哦，高一，然后。
高一，那个学校组织来春游，春游了，就从那边坐船过来，我们就全部上来这里照相。嗯。照相我一看，哎，上面的。但他动作跟我爷爷教我的动作套拳基本上动作都相似。
And in 1981, and Mr. Gan, together with the other classmates, when he was in grade one in senior high school, and they came to under the mountain to play to have the picnic, have the picnic, and after coming here, and they found wow, there is a picturesque rock art. It's quite spectacular, and some of the gestures on the rock art is quite similar to the Huashan Kung Fu.
那这从那个以后，你开始就发现，就是这个东西跟你们是有很强的联系。
对，很强的联系。嗯。而且呢，一看上去也给那个灵感，也给一个自己在练拳以后对着大自然。
Okay.And after that, they got the so much inspirations from the rock art, and they began to come here to play Huashan Kung Fu because the mountain is facing the nature and is quite natural. So
那这个从这个之后，你学了到2013年开始推广啊，现在推广的情况怎么样子的？
现在推广呢，那个在县委县政府里面的大力。那个领导下呢，我们就把那个华山拳就走进校园就对。
现在所有的校园都有这个华山拳吗？
对，就2013年以后2014年县里面就组织所有县里面的体育老师来给培训。培训回去了就每个学校里面都练华山拳。所以从小学到高中。每个学校都练
，OK，
每年都搞跨学的比赛，
每年都有比赛，
对
，OK。From 2013, and all of the primary schools and middle schools in Ninming County, and they have the courses of Huashan Kung Fu, and every student, if they want to graduate, they have to study Huashan Kung Fu. Huashan Kung Fu is one of the courses they must to study.And after study for 1 or 2 years, and the students will come to compete which one is better. And after from 2013, 1, 2, 3, 4, after 4 years right now, and the student
现在有多少个学生已经从这个练习华山拳当中受益了？
到现在应该有40,000多学生。
40,000多学生。
对，40,000多学生。
And until now, there are over 40,000 students has been benefited from the Huashan Kung Fu. They use the Huashan Kung Fu to make them stronger, and to also to make them to protect other people's attack.
那谢谢你，那感谢您给我们这个做了一个详细的介绍。